Welcome to Bible Tract Echoes. This program is the radio ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. Our mission is to take the Word of God to all the world. Our Bible teacher is the director of Bible Tracts, Pastor Mark Smith. Since 1938, Bible Tracts Incorporated has been publishing clear gospel tracts and supplying them to churches, missionaries, and individuals all over the world, and all at no charge. Information on how you can receive a free sample pack of our tracts will be given at the end of this broadcast. Now for our Bible study, here is our teacher, Pastor Mark Smith.
How do you do, my friend? Welcome to the broadcast today. What a delight to be with you, and thank you for letting us be a part of your day. If you happen to be listening to Bible Tract Echoes for the very first time, I say a very special welcome to you. We do a couple of things here. Number one, we do study the Word of God, and to that end, my Bible is sitting open to Ruth chapter 2. We are doing a verse-by-verse study through this little book of Ruth in the Old Testament. But not only do we study the Word of God, and by the way, we do that with a bent towards aiding our lives as those involved in wanting to tell the gospel of Christ, but not only do we study the Word of God, we encourage one another to give out gospel tracts. Now, just in case you don't know what a gospel tract is an evangelism tool. It's a short written presentation of God's plan of salvation. I want to give you free of charge a sample packet which contains one each of all of our English gospel tracts in it. It's got 40 tracts in there, and it's free. We've been sending out tracts for free all over the world for 81 years. I'm going to send you tracts for free. So get a piece of paper, and that piece of paper will serve a dual purpose. Number one, you'll be able to take notes from our Bible study time. We always try to give a clear outline, and we're going to do that today. But also, with that piece of paper, you'll be able to jot down our contact information. Do that. Give us then your name and mailing address so that we can send you that free sample packet. I'm going to highlight one of the tracks here in just a moment. But to get ready for the Bible study, let me begin this way. Very recently, I had the opportunity to deal with an insurance company and a car repair shop. You see, a family member's car had some real problems. These family folk were visiting us from about 500 miles away. Well, on New Year's Day, their car engine froze up due to a problem caused by a repair shop back in their hometown. Well, we had to rent a car for this family to get back home and get to work, but I had to deal with the local repair shop, and I had to deal with the insurance company from the repair shop who created the problems. Now, to my great delight, everybody took their responsibility for the engine breakdown. They took their responsibility and just did it well. The insurance company took care of all the bills plus the rental of the car, and the repair shop here locally who replaced the engine did a really tremendous job. Friend, when people show character, I want to brag on them. Well, I say that because here in Ruth chapter 2, Ruth's character stands out in a marvelous splendor. God brags on Ruth here. Now, I say that, and I have to ask myself, is God finding reasons to brag on Mark Smith these days? Get your Bible and join me there in Ruth chapter 2. I mentioned the gospel tracts a moment ago. The one in my hand right now is entitled, He is Not Here. He is not here. It emphasizes the truth of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. On the front face of this tract is a beautiful Easter lily. Now, please don't think this is only for an Easter time tract. This is a good, clear gospel tract. Preaching the resurrection as part of the story of the gospel was done all the way through the book of Acts. We ought to be doing it today. This tract emphasizes that Jesus is the Savior by making these points, that the Lord Jesus is the right man to save, He is the risen man from the dead, but lastly, He must be the received man. Unless a person receives the Lord Jesus Christ, they do not have everlasting life. If you're looking for a quality tool to share the gospel, here it is. He Is Not Here, just one of the 40 tracks in that sample packet. If you cannot stay to the full end of the program and hear our contact information, you can order that sample packet by going to our website, which is BibleTractsInc.org. Well, if your Bible is open to the book of Ruth in chapter 2, beginning at verse 17, here is what the Bible says. So she, Ruth, gleaned in the field until even, and beat out that she had gleaned, and it was about an ephah of barley. And she took it up and went into the city, and her mother-in-law saw what she had gleaned, and she brought forth and gave to her that she had reserved after she was sufficed, talking about leftover after lunchtime, verse 19 now. And her mother-in-law said unto her, where hast thou gleaned today, and where wroughtest thou? Blessed be he that did take knowledge of thee. And she showed her mother-in-law with whom she had wrought, and said, the man's name with whom I wrought today is Boaz. I'm going to stop reading right there. A moment ago, I talked about how God was bragging on people and bragging in this case upon Ruth. And just in case that phrase causes you to grimace, let me remind you of a couple of things. Number one is this: we are to give honor to whom honor is due. So when anybody, I don't mean just saved people, even lost people, when anybody displays good character, we need to notice it and honor it. But secondly, you need to go back and reread out of the book of Ephesians chapter 1, because twice there, believers are said to, their lives are supposed to be and should be to the praise of God's glory. When any believer displays Christ-likeness, it's worthy of praise. Well, here in Ruth chapter 2, verses 17 through 23, this is the fourth paragraph of the chapter. And my title for verses 17 to 23 is this: The Wisdom. The Wisdom. I've been using some W words here to form my outline. These verses are called The Wisdom. And what we're going to see here is the wisdom of Naomi. She will have the wisdom to see God at work, and then the wisdom of godly advice. To walk through these verses here, I'm going to use five words all beginning with the letter C, like in the word cat. And here we go. Number one is this. The word is complete. Complete, based upon verse 17. Verse 17 tells how Ruth stayed with her job of gleaning until it was complete. She did not do a half-baked job. That is a sign of character. Second word is the word carefulness, based upon verse 18. Ruth brought home the grain she had gleaned from the field of Boaz. But there's one more thing. At lunchtime, Ruth ate until she was full. She was sufficed. But then she saved some food from the lunchtime. And when she gets home, she is quick to give her leftovers to Naomi, her mother-in-law. Now, we're not told here, but perhaps Naomi, due to the family's plight, had not eaten anything that day, and Ruth is quick to give her something to eat. Notice the carefulness of Ruth. My third word is the word curiosity, based upon verses 19 and 20. Naomi sees the amount of grain Ruth brought home and realizes that this is more than normal. She begins with excitement to pepper Ruth with where questions. Where had Ruth been gleaning that day? And then Naomi praises God for this supply of food. And Naomi says these words that I'm reading now. Blessed be he of the Lord that hath not left off his kindness. Now, Naomi's wisdom is showing up here. She wants, yes, to bless the human individual that provided this gleaning, but she also sees God's hand in it all. This is more than normal. God is at work here. This brings me to word number four, which is the word connection, still here based upon verse 20. Immediately after Ruth answers Naomi's questions by telling her about Boaz, Naomi's brain connects all that has happened to see what God was apparently about to do. Boaz is a near kinsman to Naomi. Naomi and Ruth came back to Bethlehem from Moab without any human resources for making a life and having a future. All they had going for them was the gracious hand of God to look to, and they certainly had been doing that, and they were leaning hard on God's grace. In her wisdom, Naomi begins to see God's hand at work, not only to meet their immediate physical needs by the grain from the gleaning, but also, perchance, a long-term needs being met. So how does this chapter end? It ends with my fifth word, which is the word commitment. Commitment. I did not read verses 21 to 23, but there we see the commitment and the trust with which both Naomi and Ruth cooperate with God's plan. In verse 21, Naomi identifies the desire of Boaz. Notice the D word, the desire of Boaz to do the role of a kinsman redeemer. Then in verse 22, Naomi gives direction, my second D word, direction to Ruth. Naomi urges Ruth to stay committed to the plan of God, which seems to be unfolding. And then finally in verse 23, we see the deference shown by Ruth. Ruth defers to Naomi's advice. She sets aside any of her own ideas and will so she can obey Naomi's wisdom. Now, what are you and I looking at here? We're looking at a wise woman, a spiritually mature woman. She has the wisdom to see God at work in the details of life and the wisdom to live in cooperation with what appears to be God's plan. That is spiritual wisdom. The last time I know, I think people called this faith. They called it faith. These ladies have faith in the God who controls life's details, and faith in the plan of this God, and lastly, faith in waiting to let God work out his plan. Let me ask you, do you and I have that kind of faith? Do I have that kind of faith? You may be listening today, and you do not know Jesus Christ as your Savior. You've heard the idea that you must put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. What does that mean? It means that you are going to lean on God's plan for dealing with a sin stain on your soul. That sin stain is there because you put it there. We're all sinners. We all stain our soul by our own willful, sinful acts. We break God's law. We break the Ten Commandments. God has given us those Ten Commandments so we know what sin is. But they then are there to draw us to Christ to say, here is God's plan for salving and cleansing your soul, your sin-stained soul. Christ died on the cross out of love for you. He paid our sin debt on Calvary. That's God's plan. You and I must put our faith in God's plan to be saved. When we put our faith in Jesus Christ and what he has accomplished, we are given the gift of eternal life. Do that today.
Thank you for joining us today for Bible Tract Echoes. If you would like to receive a free sample packet of our tracts, you can contact us by calling 309-828-6888. Our mailing address is Bible Tracts, P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. Again, our phone number is 309-828-6888, and our mailing address is P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. You can also contact us through our website. Our web address is BibleTractsInc.org. Remember, the word tracts is spelled T-R-A-C-T-S. That address is BibleTractsInc.org. May the Lord richly bless you as you serve him.